Hello and welcome to In the Club. I'm your host, Caitlin Collins. I'm so excited to be here today. This is actually the first episode of this show filmed since April 11th, 2018. So I'm just really honored to be here with everyone. And today we are joined by student government. We have Caitlin Urban and Maria Doshek. So could you guys tell me a little bit about yourselves?
Yeah, so my name is Caitlin Urban. I'm a senior. My major is secondary education, social studies. I'm from Somerset, PA. On campus, I'm involved in student government as the president. I sit on the SAI board of directors. I'm a campus tour guide, and I'm part of our honors program. And within that, I'm the coaching chair on the student honors advisory board.
And my name is Maria Dovshek. I am a senior. This is my last semester. Bittersweet about that. I live in Scenery Hill, PA, so that's about 25 minutes from campus. And my major is communication studies with a minor in event planning. I am currently the student trustee. I hold a seat on the SAI board of directors with Caitlin, which I'm really excited about this semester. I am in Gamma Sigma Sigma, which is a national service sorority. And what else? I feel like I'm forgetting something. It's okay. I am interning with the cupboard, and I'm just excited to be here talking with you guys today.
Yeah, I'm so excited to have you guys today. And I will say that you two are two of the most involved people I know on campus. You guys are so busy. But yeah, so how long have you guys been in student government?
So I joined in January of 2020. It was right before COVID hit. And then I got on the executive board in spring of 2021. And now I'm president for 2021 to 2022.
And for me, I joined my first semester. So I think that was fall of 2018, maybe. I could be wrong, but I know it was my first semester here on campus.
Long time ago. I can't believe how old we are getting.
But, I know.
Could you guys tell me a little bit about student government? Like, what is like a normal meeting like, or like a normal day?
Yeah, so a normal meeting, we hold our meetings on Mondays at 4:15 in the tally 206 and 207. We all come in, we call to order, and then we go down through. We have any special presentations. So this could be food, parking, any new clubs that want to make changes to their constitution or anything like that. Then we have student concerns. So these can be from our Senate or any other student that is at the meeting that feels the need to make a concern that they think could better the student body in any way. Then we have committees, and they do their reports. We have our officer reports and then our advisor reports.
All right, and what kind of events do you guys host?
Well, we are starting to hold events after our Monday night meetings. So last week, or not last week because it was Labor Day, but the week before that, we had milkshakes for everybody. And then tonight we're having pizza, correct?
Yeah.
Yes. So just events like that. And then throughout the semester, we would like to pair up with other organizations. I know last semester we did a lot with SAB, for example, and hopefully we do similar things in the coming weeks.
Yeah, that's great. So are those like milkshake and pizza events just to like introduce yourselves to like the freshmen and stuff like that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that is great. So it's so cool that we can be back to do things like that now that we're back to in person. But what was it like when, you know, we were fully virtual because of COVID? What did you guys do? What was it like?
Well, whenever we were fully virtual, we just had the students in mind the entire time. We wanted to give back to the people that were at home, wishing that they were on campus. So we did a lot of, social media competitions, and we tried to give away gift cards and things like that. We tried to do a mental health day, and we did care baskets and things like that. Mm-hmm. Do you have anything else?
Seemed like everyone loved the social media because that was a way we could always stay connected. Even though we weren't in person, we were able to see everyone's pets, their favorite vacation spots, and just fun things like that to stay connected.
Yeah, those were super cute. And I remember I took part in a few of them because they were so cute. But do you guys get to travel? I know that now that we're back to in-person, do you have any like traveling opportunities or conferences coming up?
Honestly, things are kind of tricky right now with COVID.
Yeah, yeah.
We kind of have to play it by ear and see what happens just because it's not really in CalU's control, but just what's happening in the world right now, I don't think there's anything big for us right now.
Yeah, well, we definitely get that. Are there benefits to being in student government, like specifically with you guys being on the e-board or just for like a general member joining?
I think there's always a benefit, even if it's just meeting someone that's in the same room as you. My number one thing with student government is just the networking and the people that we meet throughout the organization.
Yeah, I definitely think it's just students love making a change on campus. So it's as easy as saying, hey, this parking meter is not working. Can we get that fixed? And it'll get fixed. But we wouldn't know that unless someone brought it to us. So I think our students really love being involved and helping out everyone else on campus.
Yeah, and with all of that being said, what do you think like the students enjoy most about being involved in student government?
I think it's just kind of like what we both said, being involved, making a change, getting to know everyone else, and then just having fun and making the most of their time here at Cal.
So do you guys have a favorite memory during your time as student government members?
I think my favorite memory was definitely the big event a few years ago. We haven't been able to do it because of COVID, but just being able to go out in the community and just give back to everybody, and I don't know, that's my favorite memory.
Yeah, I mean, mine, I haven't really been in person for that long, but I've been involved for a long time, so I think honestly, last week or 2 weeks ago, leading my first meeting and seeing everyone back in person and just like hearing how everyone's doing. And it was so nice just to see everyone again.
Yeah, that is incredible. Those are both really great memories. And I miss the big event so much. So I'm really hoping to see that make a return in the spring. But, you know, I guess we have to see how it goes. But how can students join student government?
So it's really easy. They will come to see an executive board member or even any senator. They'll get something called a senator petition, and they'll have to get 25 signatures of a CalU student. They'll bring it to our meeting, and they'll stand up and they'll say why they want to get involved, and then our Senate will take a vote on them. It's a really simple process. We're always looking for helping hands, so yeah.
And what would you say to a student who's maybe a little nervous or hesitant about getting involved?
I say just do it. You will never be forced to do anything, and if you try something you've never done before, the odds are you're probably going to like it, and if you don't want to do it, you can just quit, and you'll make friends that way, you'll learn more about the university, and you have nothing to lose, in my opinion.
That's always the best advice. Like, we always stress, like Caitlin and I as Welcome Weekend leaders, we always stress how important it is to get involved on campus. So what do you guys personally like about being involved? I know you guys do a lot.
I like making the change on campus, seeing students like have an issue, come to someone on campus, we can help solve that for them. I know with Welcome Weekend recently, it was so nice to see everyone so excited to be back involved, so appreciative of everything that we always have for them. Yeah, it's just like kind of the students and everything about CalU.
Yeah, I appreciate the opportunities, whether that's trying something new, meeting someone new, just, I don't know, the opportunities as a whole is just what I appreciate.
Yeah, I agree completely. Yeah. And to end it off, what does student government mean to both of you?
Having a voice, just being able to stand up for not only myself, but the other students that may not want to just, you know, I don't know how to put it in words, just standing up for myself and the other students.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, making that change for our students, making their 4 years here the best that it can be.
Yeah, that makes me so happy. That is so great. So for students to stay up to date with what you guys are doing, do you guys have any social medias?
Yeah, we do. So we use Instagram and Twitter, and you can follow us at CalU Student Gov.
That's great. And I know you guys are always posting, so there's always something for students to be on the lookout for. And I just want to thank you both for being here today. I know it's a little nervous. It's the first show, but I was so excited to have you guys here first. And yeah, so we will be back next with the CalU Cheerleaders. And like I said, I'm just so honored to be here. In the Club is a nice little platform that we can use to help show off all the clubs and organizations we have on campus. We have over 100 of them. So I'm just really thankful to have this opportunity to get to meet and speak with people from all around campus. So thank you, and we will be right back.
Looking for something to do? Then don't miss the 2021 Health Fair. This year, the Health Fair will be on Wednesday, October 6th in the Convocation Center Arena from 11 a.m. until 2 p.m. There will be free STD testing, a blood drive, prizes, free health screens, flu and COVID vaccines, giveaways, and much, much more. Don't miss the excitement. Be at the Convocation Center on October 6th for the 2021 Health Fair.
The Cal-U Cupboard connects students to information, services, and resources both on and off campus while providing free items such as food, school supplies, personal hygiene items, and more to our students. Visit our two locations at the Vulcan Village Clubhouse and Italy Student Center, or for a contactless option, visit bit.ly.com/CalUCupboard to request food or give donations. For important Cal-U information, community resources, and our how-to series, follow at CalUCupboard on Instagram and the campus-wide announcements.
Okay, Daddy, Dr. Elmo says you're healthy.
Oh, well, thank you. Our children and families want us to be healthy. That's why I and lots of other grown-ups got the COVID-19 vaccine, so we can stay healthy and get back to the moments we miss, like seeing our friends and family.
Here you go, Daddy, for a healthy checkup, a sticker.
Oh, thanks, son.
With free COVID-19 vaccines, sunnier days are ahead. Visit getvaccineanswers.org.
Vulcan Volleyball is back, and you can catch all the action with CUTV and the PSAC network. After a year away from the court, the Vulcans are set to try and get back to the top of the PSAC. A full slate of action versus such PSAC opponents Gannon, Mercyhurst, Edinburgh, Clarion, Seton Hill, Slippery Rock, IUP, and Pitt Johnstown. Every home game will be live on CUTV Sports 1 and the PSAC network.
Welcome back to In the Club. We had a great conversation with student government, but now we are here with a member of the Cal-U cheer team. So we have Karina McKinney with us. How are you doing today?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. So could you tell me a little bit about yourself?
I'm a senior. I'm the vice president for the cheer club. I'm a social work major. I'm from Bethel Park, so South Hills. Yeah,
that's great. I love the South Hills. I'm always at the mall. But how long have you been involved in Cal-U cheer?
Since my freshman year, so 4 years, and then I've been a cheerleader for 14 years.
Wow, that is awesome. So could you tell me a little bit about your club? Like, do you guys have meetings? Like, what do you guys do?
We have practices 2 days a week. Right now it's Monday and Wednesday. We practice with stunts, we practice cheers and dances, and then we condition and team bond.
That's great, and I applaud you for everything you do because not flexible, so it's really cool to see like everything you guys can do. So what kind of do you guys like host events, or do you mainly just do like the games?
We mainly cheer for football and then men's and women's basketball, and then we compete sometimes as well. Hopefully we're gonna be able to compete this year.
That's awesome. I hope so too. So what was cheer like when we were completely virtual with the pandemic? Did it change a lot?
Yeah, unfortunately we weren't able to do anything at all. We did have a few Zoom meetings. We had a tryout fully online. We had to send in a video, but yeah, we basically just had Zoom meetings twice.
Yeah. I'm sure that was definitely like strange for a while, wasn't it? But like, were you able to keep up like bonding and stuff like that, close connections?
Yeah, we have a bunch of group chats, and then we all formed like friendships from it, which is nice to have.
Yeah. So do you guys, I know you said that you sometimes get to compete, do you get to travel a lot? Like, do you go to the away games and everything like that?
We don't go to every away game. There are certain football games that we get to go to, and then for women's basketball and men's basketball, if they make it to like championships, we get to go to those.
Yeah, that's really cool. Do you have like a preference? What do you like cheering for the most, like football or basketball?
I love football.
Yeah. I get that. I get that for sure. So what are some benefits that benefit like you and just other members of being a part of the Cal-U cheer team?
So there's about 40 of us on the team.
Wow.
So you get to see familiar faces like when you're going to class. Like I said, we all form like friendships. So it's just nice to have like people like to go back to for like support, for like guidance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what do you think the members enjoy the most about being a part of the team?
Well, we all definitely share like a passion for something. So definitely just doing what we love to do, which is cheer. So it's just nice to share that. common thing.
Mm-hmm. And do you have any like favorite memories or anything like specific that stands out through your time here?
My sophomore year, so 2 years ago, we got to do homecoming, and we actually did the homecoming float, and we won that. Then we actually won the football game that day.
Oh, wow.
So it's just fun.
So are you guys going to do the float again this year?
We are not going to be doing a float, but we will be cheering in the parade, hopefully, this year.
Yeah, that's great. So are you excited? Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, I love homecoming.
It's definitely so exciting, and it's coming up so fast.
It
but
is.
It's a really great time of the year where everybody can come together, so I'll be excited to see you guys there. So for students who are potentially looking to join the cheer team, how can they join, and like who can join?
We have a tryout like in the spring around April, and then we have a tryout in the fall, which we just had a tryout about a week ago now. For any girls who are like late committing to Cal, you can try out in the fall.
And what are the tryouts like?
We learn a cheer and a dance, and then if you have tumbling, you can throw your tumbling skills.
Okay, that's really cool. What would you say, just like in general, to students who are a little bit nervous or hesitant about being involved? Because I know it can be like a scary first step sometimes.
You just have to be confident with yourself. It's so welcoming. It's a warm environment. You just feel very welcome joining.
Yeah, I definitely agree 100%. And what does cheer mean to you? And that's just like in general, but also just like you specifically, since you said this has been what, like 18 years of cheering for you?
Yeah, 14, yeah.
Oh, 14 total, yeah. 14 total, oh my gosh.
Well, I have grown a lot as a person, I feel like. It just has brought me out of my shell. Again, I said, like, it's just very welcoming. So you just grow a lot as a person being a cheerleader, I feel.
Yeah. That's great. That makes me so happy. Just like getting to hear about like what makes everybody else happy and their clubs and orgs and everything. It's a really cool experience. But so do you have any social medias that you guys use where students can keep up to date with what you're doing?
We have a Facebook, an Instagram, and a Twitter, and it's CalU Cheer Official.
All right. Well, you guys should look out for that. Give them a follow. But thank you so much for coming down here today.
Well, thank you.
I really appreciate it. So yeah, just a big thanks to CalU Cheer, to student government. I really appreciate everyone coming out. If you are a part of a club or an organization and you want to be featured on In the Club, just send us a DM on Instagram. That's at CUTV_PA. So thank you for watching, and we'll see you again next time.